Close your eyes, Mr. Kipling told my grandson, and tell me what you can taste.
No! God, please, no!
It was a caramel shortcake, a soft, crumbly shortcake base topped with chewy caramel and a figure of eight design. The boy gave his verdict.
It's fucking horrible,
he said, and this was a compliment, it seems.
Let me put it this way. If it isn't here Thursday, none of us will have jobs on Friday.
Don't worry, it'll be there.
Punjab Airways entire fleet now flies daily to one destination worldwide. Luxuriate in sumptuous Maharaja class. Enjoy authentic spiced delicacies. Until you arrive relaxed in the cultural center of Europe.
Five.
Captain
Cameron! Four.
And off goes the rocket. Hello. Hello, everyone. How's everyone doing? Getting the levels right. Nice of you all to turn up for the last one. This is the last one. Hiya, Judean People's Front splitters. Made me laugh. Actually, it's the People's Front of Judea. Or is it the Popular People's Front? I forget. How's everyone doing? Let's see loads of people. Hello, Rita H. Hello, Jimmy. Can you hear me all right? Let me know. hey, Chris R. Kevin Godin, Jimmy Riddle Show, Gunter Bortz, Chris Tyler, Mark Hodgson, Sherry Lynn, Judean People's Front, Mark Dennison, Kevin Godin. Nice of you. Joe Clark is in. Jeremy Hollier is in. Rita H. Hambo. McKittip. CGS, how you doing? Nice to see you, Mike. Lee S. Mark Dennison. Oh, is that everyone? Chris R. Those were the first Madvits I've ever made. Yeah, those I thought I'd go right back to the start. Ricky J. Cool Show. No, not Richie. Got to keep up with it. Coroidal. Rachel, Joe Clark, Hambo. I think that's everyone. I'm sorry if I've missed you out. I don't think I've got everyone. It's tough. It's a bit like that generation game. You have to name everything as it goes past on the conveyor belt. Yes, for the last one, had to wear the Alabama Crimson Tide. Good job I stopped watching that game the other night, wasn't it? They were losing terribly. And that's how it seems to go when I watch sports. That's why I'm not really into sport, because whoever I watch loses terribly. So I'll do my best never to watch again, and you should be right. Terry Miles is in. Good evening, Terry. Thank you for coming along. It's the last one. It's hard to convince people of that. I'm not quite sure what that is. Is it because I've invested so much money in this? Oh, better tune this up a bit, haven't I? So this stream is a bit different to most of them. Tuning guitar. I went too far. I've got to go back now. There's still top of the comments. But what I normally do for a stream is I basically, during the week, I hear songs that I like and go, oh, I could possibly do that. And then I bookmark them and things like that. I've done nothing. There is literally zero plan for this stream. So if anyone wants to make suggestions or requests, you know my sort of stuff by now, then feel free to make a request. Let's turn the old guitar amplifiers on here. Check we're in good territory for sound. Thank you. foot switchy thing's not working. Why is that? Oh, because I haven't... There we go. I haven't turned that on either. That appears to be working all right. So how are we all? Hiya there, Judean people. So shackle for the leper? Shackle for the leper, what is it? Right, anyone playing along at home? Because it's the last one, I've gone all out on the beverage this evening. We've got a mixture of Coca-Cola. So it's one part Coca-Cola. It's all the way over here. I spotted this on the shelf today and I thought, oh, we must have some of that. silver coupage. Double silver filtration vodka. Apparently. Made in Russia. Delicate softness, crystal purity, and pleasant aftertaste. The secret of these exceptional qualities lies in our double silver filter. No, fuck. It's cheap vodka. wait till biggest dick is here of everything that goes on around here. I've gone blue for the background today, by the way. Again, just changing it up slightly. So we'll use about that much. That's a good helping, isn't it? Da, the Russians do make good vodka. We need Lee in. The urban fat kid. He can translate to Russia. Spasiba. Opa! That's what we should be saying, everyone. Raise a glass. You know, this is boring, isn't it? Everything's happening off camera. There we are. Opa. To a health. Skull. 38%. Katrina. 38. It's an 8. Lemonade spiked with a bit too much vodka here. Da! Hey, Sherry Lynn. Whoopa! So, yes, it's going to be completely fly-by-the-pants stream. Anyone got any ideas what to do? I got nothing. And it is the last one, so here's what's happening. This is the regular Monday stream. Let me talk to you for a minute. Or should we do a song first? Anyone get any requests? maybe a Beatles song or something. I've got a few that I were going to do last week and I never got around to them. So they were sort of Halloween-y, but they never really got... we went off in a different direction. So I think we went off Ace of Spades instead. But we could have a go at one of those. I'm looking at that. How does that go? I'm not going to do that one. Let's see if we can start with this. Salutations, Sir Terry Miles. Yes, indeed. See now here's another thing. We've got a lot. There's a few things to talk about. End of the stream being one. Hey, Cookie in the Haylands, UK eBay reseller. Thanks for coming along. It's one of Jimmy Riddle's mates. I recognise you anywhere. there's stuff to talk about. What's going on? Why this is the last one? But I just want to sort of play a song. Let's start something off. And we'll see where we go. Again, you have to help me with levels and things. Can we hear this? All right. Mm-hmm. assume you can. Don't stop it while it's playing. Oh no, I've got a problem. Alright, that's sorted that, I think. Sounds good. That's all right. We'll go with it. We had no way of staying afloat. We had to leave on a ferry boat. Economic refugees on the run to Germany. We had the back of Maggie's hand. Times were tough in Geordie land. We got what tools and working gear and humped it all from Newcastle to here. Why I man? Why I? Why I man? Why I man? Why I? Why I man? Why I man? Why I? Why I man? Why I man? Traveling boy, why I, in the dust and the dirt and the racking and the noise, why I, drilling hammers, diggers and picks, why I, mixing concrete, laying bricks. There's English, Irish, Scots, the lot. United Nations, what we got? Rickies, chipperies, every trade, German built and British made. Why I man? Why I? Why I man? Why I man? Why I man? Why I man? On Maggie's farm, hide away down the Audubon, mind to port a cabin bed or a bunk in a missing hut instead. Deutschmarks here to earn, and German tarts are wunderschön. German beer is chemical free. Germany's alright with me. Sometimes I miss my river time.
Oh, what? I shouldn't be there.
It's gone wrong. Why I man? Sometimes I wish my river tight, but you're my pretty Fraulein. Tonight we'll drink the whole town dry, keep our spirit levels high.
every time, but you're my pretty fraulein. Tonight we drink the whole town dry, keep our spirit levels high. I miss my river time, you're my pretty fraulein. Tonight we drink the old town dry, keep our spirit levels high.
I was going to do that a couple of weeks ago. Now I remember why. It doesn't follow the song. So anyway, slight apologies for that, but thank you. Thank you, Jimmy Riddle Show, Joe Clark. I should have like an applause after every song, shouldn't I? Oh, this is playing up again. All right, no applause. No applause for anyone. Thank you, Matt Dennison. CNK, Joe Clark, Jimmy Riddle Show, Rita H. You have to ask Lammy, Becca Music. What would you like to ask me? Why is this the last live stream? It just is. It's the improv at the Lamb. It will be missed. So here's the thing. Tina will probably be doing it because Lammy. Roll Tide. Roll Tide indeed. Why is it the last one? It is the last one for a while. It's not the end of this. But here's the thing, right? Last week, the Halloween stream was probably the most fun that I've had on a stream in quite a while. Not in quite a while. It was sort of, they got better and better, I felt. Maybe not in terms of performance, but in terms of how the show's been going. And what we'll do is a bit later, when we've got time, I'm gonna go back and we'll look at what the first show was like and how bad it was. And we'll look at a couple of things. I'll show you some of the stats and the figures on the channel. Basically, full transparency. I'll show you everything that's going on. Because it's been amazing so far doing this stream. And I've got a real problem with my OBS. Doesn't want to. I've not got like the top bar. I can't drag it around. The top bit's missing. Anyway, thank you, Terry. So yeah, so I have done now, would you believe it, 35 Monday night streams weekly on the bounce. Every single one, a complete improv 2 hours. And they've got better and better. I've got new things. I've got like the lasers and the lights and a few other things. Got the smoke machine. Is that on today? Smokey? You smoking? He's smoking. You know, we've got all of these things. And that's always fun. But the main reason I've done it is because of everyone in the chat that's come along to this. This is a tiny channel. 350 subscribers. And that's one of the reasons I'm going away. And yeah, every time I do this now, it's about 30 people, all you wonderful people, all turn up to watch this nonsense. And that's amazing. It's absolutely amazing. Because I started this at the start of lockdown. Full lockdown, really, just for a bit of fun. I was hanging around in Brent Hutchinson's stream, who's actually streaming now. Bastard's gone up against me. And he wanted some videos, and I've done a couple of things, And then I started making videos, which were like showing off bits of gear. You know, like everyone does, oh, this is this guitar, and this is this pedal, and this is that. But I'm not an expert on that. And there are millions of channels, but there's so many channels that do that stuff better that I thought, oh, well, it'd just be a bit of fun. Then I got into making pedals, and I made a few fuzz things, and I've got completed circuit boards that need to go into pedals all around the place here. I can literally, I mean, look at these, they're everywhere. So that's I don't know what that is. It's a chorus, I think. This is some things with Captain Ray Paul's here. There's more down here. So and that was fun, making pedals and giving them away. This, I believe this is not the wet wipe, toilet paper, the dirty used tissue. This is a Klon, I think, pedal that I made. So I've, you know, I've got things like that I need to do and send out and stuff. And I promised lots of you lots of things, and I haven't delivered them yet. So I'm going to take some time. And if I basically, here's the thing: if I'm going to go through my emails after this, if I've got your address, I'm going to send you something for Christmas. Between now and Christmas, I'm going to send you something. So keep an eye on the post. That should tide you over. So there will be no more live streams after this one. And the reason is, as fun as it is and everything else, I can't keep this up. I can't keep up the quality. Here's what's going to happen. I'm going to start repeating myself on the songs. I'm going to start finding that less fun. It's going to become less fun. You guys are going to start hearing the same things again and again. You know, the Madverts now, like I said to Mark Dennison, I said, oh, it's the last one I'll make Madverts. I watched adverts for 2 hours, couldn't think of like one joke that I could make into Madverts. So that's sort of the, so I feel like I've mined this, whatever this is, as much as I can for what it's worth. And I don't want to drag you guys in here. Not that, I mean, you freak the way you want, but I don't want you to keep coming back to the same old shit. You know what I mean? Part of the fun of this is that, like, things that have come out of this that never would have thought of, like the sex butter thing. I'm wearing Alabama bloody Roll Tide shirts from the thing. I've got Captain Ray Paul's slide here that he sent in. You know, all this wonderful community stuff. And so I don't want it to become run of the mill. I don't want to take it for granted. So I'm going to stop. I'm going to go away. And while I'm away, there will still be videos. But one of the things I wanted to show you, I'm sorry if I'm ignoring you a bit, chat. More than 40 in the live stream. Jonathan Coe has more than 24,000 followers, and it gets no one. This is the thing. This is exactly, Gunter, this is exactly what I'm talking about. Tiny channel, the amount of people that turn up and enjoy this is phenomenal. So, this, to me, and here's the other thing. I was talking about this on the Basement Guitar Superstar on his channel. Is that there's a problem with YouTube, a very difficult problem. If you're in a band, you can play the same act and you take your act around the country and you go and see all different groups of people. So you'll see 20 people here, 50 people there, 100 people there, and you go round and round and round. The act never changes. And that's great. You get different reaction on sometimes. Sometimes it goes off. Sometimes it's not so good. And you learn and you get really good at that one act. And that's great. I love that, to be honest. That's a really good bit of being a working musician, is to hone your craft on a specific sort of piece of kind of theatre or whatever your show is. So that's live. Now, what it used to be on TV is that you had a captive audience. So you used to get, like, you know, in the old days, millions of people, but people will sit down and watch TV and they watch a show. And that show is created, and lots of money, lots of time goes into it, lots of people work on it. So they change the show and the audience stays static. So now you've got a static audience and a changing show. Keeping that show fresh is kind of impossible. Faulty Towers, a friend of mine said, oh, you're pulling these people in, why are you stopping? And I said, well, Faulty Towers stopped at its peak. I'm going to do the same. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go away and I'm going to dream it all up again, so to speak, to use a phrase from about a certain band. And so we're going to come back. I will be the next live stream. There will be one. It's not the final end of final. The next live stream is going to be Christmas Day. That'll be a Christmas special. Christmas Day afternoon, probably maybe 4 or 5 o'clock. I see it'll advertise. The Discord will keep going. Facebook's, nothing's closing down. I'm not dying or anything like that. I'm just having a break. So there'll be a live stream on Christmas Day. There will be a live stream a week later on New Year's Day. So those are the next two live streams. That's all I'm saying at this point. Those two will be easier for me because it's Christmas. We can do Christmas songs. It's New Year. And so we can get drunk and do a few other things. So, and it'll still be Christmas. So that's all fine. So that's quite an easy one to do. But general run-of-the-mill shows. Season is over, folks. This is the last episode of the season. That's the way to look at it. And then when I'm satisfied, the next thing I do is going to be worth your time. Worth, you know, my type of fun, entertaining, different. You know, if we don't change this up, I know, Jimmy, and I'm going to miss you too. And the closer I've got to this stream, I've been more like, oh, maybe I shouldn't do this, and I felt sad about it. But here's, let me show you one other thing, right? Let's get a desktop camera here. Here's my door. Let me show you. All the things you shouldn't do as a YouTuber, but I don't care, right? Because it's important to be clear about these things, right? This channel doesn't do very well at all, right? At all. So if we look at the last, forget the last 20 days, we look at the last year, right? Here's the last year on the channel. My top videos this year have been the smoke machine, the foot pedal I use, the interface I use, how I set up a door, Line 6 interface, UMC, how to stream. So do you see the theme here? None of these are live streams. And then there's a couple of the more recent ones down here, and they're only there because they're recent. Like shows in the 50s don't show up on here. Anything. So I'm doing all of this stuff, and literally what's happening is every 2 hours these shows, they get buried, they get lost to time. And what bubbles to the top are these product vids. So in order to keep the channel alive, I'm going to have to do some more of this stuff. So I'm going to do this between now and when I come back. There will be videos, but they're going to be more like this stuff because these get the views. You see, I started doing the live streams here, and every one of these peaks is a live stream. But if you ignore those, this is actually kind of going downhill. You know, so... And what will happen, and here's the other problem you see, is if we don't do this, if I can't promote the channel, it's going to be the same bunch of us coming in all the time. I'm going to get bored of each other, and the show's going to get boring, it's going to get repetitive, and it'll just peter out and die. So I don't want that. So I'm killing it in order for it to be born again, better, stronger. I mean, the subscriber count, literally, week to week now, four new subscribers last week. So no one new is coming. It's just us, which I like, and it's been great. So if you want to, between now and Christmas or whenever you can, if you want to help share this channel around or think you can promote it or get some more people along or whatever, do that. It's not going away, and that's a massive help because it's all word of mouth. YouTube doesn't advertise this channel. Just doesn't. I got no interest because I play copyright stuff, don't care. So my point is, if it carries on like this, I'm going to get worse. No one else is going to come. You're all going to get bored of it. Trust me, top of the comments and all of that. The lovely thing about Halloween was being able to mix it up and chuck that silly horror video in there. And I like all of that. It was good, but I can't do that every stream. It didn't bother you, Mark Dennison, that you were playing the 2-6 people for months when you started doing lives. No, and I could do that. I just don't want to because... I want to put more into it. I'm not saying you don't. But your show's kind of different. I mean, your show's a result of all of those shows that you've put in. You know what I mean? So now people can turn up and say, "Hey, can you play this?" And you go, and you can play it, and it's incredible. And your songbook is huge. I don't have that. Every song I've sang, and here's the other thing, right? Christmas this year was the first time I sang on stream, and it's the first time I sang publicly. I'm not a singer. I'm a guitarist and a producer and things, but not a singer. So that's what's going to happen. So the live streams are going to stop to give me a bit of a break, to give me some time. For example, right, this room is small and crappy, and this is the same wallpaper I had when I moved in. One of the reasons I have coloured lights in the background is this wallpaper is filthy. The hands over the you can see there, you see. I never show you much wider than this point because the wall gets a bit dirty, and I've tried to clean it, but it's bloody textured wallpaper, so it starts to soak up the water and sponge off. So I could strip the place, I could paint it, I could rearrange, maybe turn 90 degrees. We'll have like a new studio sort of thing. I want to get some better lights. I want to get lights. At the moment, all the color, there's just four lights up in the ceiling that I've got one of these, and I can press buttons and get a colour. I want to get some proper DMX-controlled RGB parkans that I can put around, and then the lights can be programmed to the songs. So when I'm playing a backing track, and give you an example of this, right? Because I've got one prepared. I'm heading down to the crossroads. I've already been, actually. No, I will never come back ripping it up like EVH. Not a chance, unfortunately. So that's what I said. So it's not the end of everything, but it's the end of live streams for now. I am sorry, but because you're so cool the way you're coming on. So please, if you can, stick around on the channel so that when it'll start back up again, but it'll be a while, and then we'll come back maybe in the new year, bigger, stronger. Who knows what will happen between now and then? That's the other thing. I'll run out of stories, you know. Who knows what's going to happen between now and then? Here's one thing I know. January, and towards the end of January, there is a session booked in a studio in a secret location. And I'm going to meet with some other YouTubers. And we're going to get together having a jam and record it and maybe live stream some stuff. And all that will be going off in January. So there's that to look forward to. And there'll be some other things, I'm sure, as well. You can always buy merch. Yep, the merch isn't going to go away. That'll just sit there happily. The merch is fine. My light, our sound to light, very good to have that. Yes, it'd be nice to get a movement. I've got the old laser here, which is fun for like 2 minutes. But I want to do more. I can kind of demonstrate. Right? I did a thing a while ago. There will be frozen lamp. I'm worried about getting it, to be honest. I hope it's not too bad, because it'll be a bloody electric car. If it's too cold, it won't make it. here's an example of what I mean, right? I'm going to turn off some of these lights. I never had this one when I did it. So let's turn this off. See how dark it is when I turn it off? Right, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put that down there. Let's see if we can create a mood here, right? A bit of smoke. Gonna do a mood. Now, don't worry if you can't see me. It's all part of the moodiness. You can see the guitar down there. Oh, look, the merch things. That's not very moody. Right, merch. So this is a very, very simple example of how lights can coordinate a bit with the music. Check my guitar loud enough, I'm sure it's fine. Sorry, this takes a lot of while to set up. What I want to have is like a load of backing tracks, MP3, tied to light shows, nothing major, but just so that it looks more interesting, more dynamic. That'll be one of the things that will come in season 2 of The Lamb Life. Right, chat, you go over there. Yeah, I've got an IFR at night. I'm not qualified at all either. I just do my usual. I'll squawk 7700 and pretend the pilot's dead or something. Yeah. Oh, it's not my fault. I just drifted into this airspace. pilot jokes. That's not hitting much of the audience, is it? Not landing many of them. Oh, pilot joke again. Look at that. Well, it's just for you, Captain. Oh, God. Right. Okay. Let's try this. Where is it? I'll pause it a minute. Just a second. Chat goes over there. See, it's not full screen now. Why is it doing that? Why is it that OBS is playing up? Right. Information. It's in the diary. This is my investigation. public inquiry. I've been checking out the reports, and I'm digging up the dirt. You get to meet all sorts in this line of work, alright? Treachery and treason, there's always an excuse for it. And when I find the reason, I still can't get used to it. And what have you got at the end of the day? What have you got to take away? A bottle of whiskey and a new set of lies. Blinds on the windows and a pain behind the eyes. Going to be a Halloween one. Hello, you're all right, you're still there. Get that bloody light on. There we go. that's the best I can do for that sort of thing. Come back, chat. Was there a backing track? Yeah, there must have been. There must have been. That would reek grand. You did hear the backing. Yeah, it must have worked. Thank you very much, Private Investigations. I was going to do that for Halloween, and then we got sidetracked, and so I didn't. Rita H, Brexit, Chris R, CNK, Captain Ray Paul, Reed Shield, Joe Clark. Thank you. I'm honing it. Choroidal. You're honing your air triangle skills. It's a tricky instrument triangle. It's very tricky. I've been watching Mark Dennison try. I don't know. It's a tricky instrument. Why is my face so bloody red? What's
that all about?
It's probably all the vodka. Private Investigations, Dire Straits. Yeah. So all I could do there is basically that all that is the backing track is a video, but when it's going bomb, bomb, the video just goes from a white screen to a black screen and sort of back to make a sort of a light that bumps in time with the music. Drink, consume. Cheers. Cheers, Lee. Yes. But you imagine that. So a song like that, so I've got a few lights around and they can all kind of come on and go off and in time with the music. And, oh, it'd be great. Richard Grutter's. What, really? Was Richard Grutter's in? Or was he just on the phone? Kevin Smith, how you doing? Becca Music, nice to see you. Sorry if you've come in and I missed you. You won't know what to do with yourself for 2 hours on a Monday evening there, Rita. I've got a suggestion. What was that, Lammy? Oh. Quarter to eight. Thought for the day. Do carbonated drinks start off heavy and get lighter as they go flat? Or do they start off light and get heavy as they go flat? Ooh. Ooh. Now, bloody hell, Simon. The thing is, the carbonate is in the drink, isn't it? Because it's not coming out of the drink. We were saying when it does come out, so when it and rise up, is the drink then lighter? Oh, but then the fact that it's coming out is because it's lighter than the liquid. Is it lighter than the air? Oh, I don't know. please, if anyone has any scientific explanation as to what the hell Simon has come up. It's like Stephen Wright, the American comedian, said this thing. He went for a job interview. As he sat down, before the interview started, he said to the interviewer, he said, I want to ask you a quick question. The interviewer says, oh, okay. He says, if I'm traveling in my car at the speed of light and I switch on the headlights, do they come on? And the guy says, I don't know. And he says, oh, forget it. I don't want to work for you then. Carbon dioxide is heavier than air. Right, so there we go, Chris. So the drink will get lighter as the carbon dioxide is released, is your view. Yes. But does that mean that is there then just a layer of carbon dioxide above the liquid? I guess so. Yeah. But that's another melon scratcher. I can't help it. I've random thoughts into, yeah, shower thoughts, isn't it? I came up with one the other day and I can't remember what it was now. Like the ways in buildings should be called built because they're not building. A building is a process of erecting the building. When it's finished, it's built. So they should be called builds, not buildings. And I've thought about it. It's gone now. I should have written it down. I think it gets lighter when Mars and Jupiter line up with Pluto. As long as whatever's happening with Uranus, that's all I'm interested in. Oh, well, if you watch QI, that's cheating, yes. Heavier than air nature by pouring out into a box where its effects can be seen. Yeah, well, like hexafluoride. Sodium hexafluoride, is it? What's that, really, like 18 times denser than air? And you can float little things on it, and when you breathe it, it makes your voice go really low, but it's way more dangerous than helium because its weight means it actually stays in your lungs a lot longer. Uranus. I always like that. I remember that. The sky at night. Patrick Moore. He had the best. He had the best way of getting around it. He used to call it Uranus. Uranus with his monocle. Yeah, Uranus. Uranus is light up. Did you know that the Earth can fit inside Uranus 65 times? Or 66 if you relax a little. You can sing I Got a Brand New Bicycle to that ditty. Oh, could you? Oh, I got a brand new bicycle. You could probably do that. Better with that echo. And yet no one has anyone suggested any songs yet, by the way. I'm sorry if I've missed anyone. Has anyone said, have a go? If you know I've done stuff in the past, it's like Phantom of the Opera. The Phantom of the Opera is a ripoff of Pink Floyd Echoes. Maneuvers in the Dark. Yeah, there's been plenty of that. Sorry, just going back. Captain, are you in your party suit? Are you watching the show naked? Let's be careful. Johnny Be Good. There we go. Let's have a go at that, shall we? We did the Time Warp last week. It's the same song. Let's see if we can find the Johnny Be Good backing track in the correct key. Let's turn off the echoiness because we don't need that now. That was for atmosphere. Like a party with an atmosphere right there. How's that? That'll work. All we need now. It's not clipping anywhere, is it? No. Is the right backing track? Which one is it? Oh, I think it's this one. Right. Sympathy for the Devil. Well, we can do that one again, yeah. This show's all about you. It's all about you. That was great, CGS. Was that the one of your your daughter that was singing? Or was it a nephew or a niece? If you're still here. I really enjoyed that, by the way. Okay. Talent. This one says it's in A. Let's hope it's in A. That sounds right. That's just an intro thing. Come on, get on with it. It's coming, it's coming. I always forget that second one.
gonna tell me someday you will be a man. You will be the leader of a big old band. Man, and people coming from miles around. When he playing music, let the sun go down. Maybe it's a plane you need to light. Say, Johnny, be good tonight. Go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go, go.
Oh. Oh, that's just the end music. Backing track could have been louder there, but there we go. Johnny be good. What a riff to come up with that, mind you there. Great stuff. Thank you, Batman. Thank you. Why is this chat not catching up? Now it's catching up. Thank you, Captain Ray Paul, CNK, Sherry Lynn, Brexit, Sandor, Kevin Godin, Rita H, Reed Shields, 177. Alrighty then. That's a bit of a... Blimey, this is a blast from the past. Jim Carrey references. Buddy Holly by Weezer. Ooh, you look just like Buddy Holly. I only know that song because it was on the Windows 95, I think. The Windows 95 media CD. They had a special, or it might be 98. It had a special CD-ROM. And it had some song, like an urban woman singing something kind of soulful. And that song was on it as well. And like in 1995, I must have, or 98, whenever it was. I must have watched it like a gajillion times. I think I can remember it now. It was set in Happy Days, wasn't it? In the bar. Anyone remember this? Really obscure. Chris R, you're about the only person I think who might remember this. The old Windows 98, was it? That had Weezer, Buddy Holly on there. Prodigy, oh my gosh. No, I got... Unfortunately not. Prodigy, I wouldn't even know where to start. Like... just wouldn't have a clue. Guitar, singing it. I'm not saying I don't like it. I like it. I love Prodigy. Very cool. I was a bit, little bit old. That was it. Oh, Simon Ferry remembers. Like Eddie Brickell singing Good Times. Yeah, Good Times. About to give me some of that. Some, it was 95, was it? Bloody hell. Don't tell me how many years ago that is. Nearly, how many years ago is that? Is that nearly 30 years ago? No. Oh, shit. This is the end, my friend. The Doors. Oh, see, these are all good stuff. See, this is one of the reasons I'm finishing, you see, because all of this stuff is really good. But I can't do it because it's not in here, you know what I mean? Just to do it, you need to know how to play it and have a few cracks at it at least. So again, that's the other thing. When I'm away, I can try some more different stuff. Can I play Revolution? Yes, we can probably do a Revolution. What number? Should we do Revolution 9? Number 9. Number 9. I could probably do that. Hang on. Number 9. Number 9. So that, and then what you got to do is you take that and you do that. The camera's in the way. Number 9. Number 9. Hang on, I'll get there. Number 9. Right. Number 9. And now that's going on, I've got number to nine. Make some tape noises. Number 9. Number 9. Well, let's try some number backwards, nine. Backwards guitar. Number 9. Number 9. Number 9. I mean, so it sounds like a car going past number and nine. Number 9. Number 9. Number 9. There we go. Revolution 9. How was that? That's all I know. Because there's Revolution 1, which I quite like, which is the White Album one. And then there's Revolution something else. So we've got to try and figure out what key they're in. Like, here's one. Okay, so we're doing that one. So which one is that? Revolution. So that one's in A. This is a really distorted one. And I can't remember how that starts. Oh, no, no, that's not in A. That's not in A, that's in B flat. I can solve that with a capo if I knew where it was. Can't see my capo, it's really smoky in here. No, it's gone. Okay. Still working on it. There's one in B. This one's in, this backing track's in B flat. Let's get a different backing track. Ah, we can work with, there we go. That one's in the right key. We'll work with that. Can't remember that opening riff. I had the chords up in B and the song was in A. Right here, this is it now. You say you want a revolution. Destruction. Don't you know that you can count me out? Don't you know it's gonna be alright? Alright. You know it's gonna be alright. You say you got a real solution. For people with minds and hate, all I can tell her is, brother, you have to wait. Don't you know it's gonna be alright? Alright. Alright. You say you change your constitution. All right. Oh. Ah, we got there in the end. Thank you for your patience. Good suggestion. Cracking suggestion. Thank you very much. Mark Dennison, was it? Excellent suggestion. Thank you, Swanger. Thank you, Reshiel. Jimmy Riddle Show. Reese H. Chris R. Hiding under the... About time they got rid of that Halloween hat now thing, isn't it? Surely. Joe Clark got the speakers blasting. Batman says, all right. Katrina Dennison, oh, look at the fire in the guitars. I was put one in the chat save, like, yeah, that's a good idea. Hit the like button. Oh, I can't wait for Analog Corner, Terry. That's what's going to keep me going during my break. Now, that would be cool while I'm on a break, wouldn't it? If I could just pop up in your Analog Corner. Just a little bit of guitar backing or something. I won't come to the Sunday service because it's too irreverent for me. I'd bring the tone down, but... Yes, Terry Miles is on YouTube this Thursday, 5 p.m. GMT UK. Please go see Terry. See, if you want to stick a link to Terry's channel in the chat, that's fine by me. Pam Dean, I thought it was Pam Ayres then, the late great, no, great Pam Ayres. Right, so there we go. That's what happens when you make a request. Not always. In fact, that's rarely what happens. This is all the people that have asked me stuff I can't do. Let's do top of the comments. We haven't done that yet, have we? Here we go. Eyes down, look in, press the button. I can go over there. Here we go. Last one for a while. Who will be number one? Who's going to be the pop princess? Yeah, well, let's find out. Top of the comments. For the last time for quite a while, it's top of the comments. At number 10, it's Chris R. Who says... Hang on. Top of the comments is behind the chat. We can't have that. Eyes down, look in. It's take two of top of the comments now in the chat. Number 10, Chris R. Saw balls. That's a nasty situation, Chris. Number 9 is Gunter Bortz, who says slap it. Brexit Central's at number 8 with transvestite. At number 7 is Lee S. Don't say the W word. I wonder what that could be. Number 6 is Croydal. I'm off to Lee Ho Fuck. They do a good Chinese, so I hear. Terry Miles, absolutely, oh boy. Richie J Show, up is Jaxi, right up. And at number 3 is Sherry Lynn, forsooth. At number 2, it's Pixie Mel, who says, I'm just a virtual signal. And at number 1, the final top of the comments, our pop princess is Mayhem, who says, hashtag, Crispin is innocent. He may be innocent, but he still has to sweep the chimney. Not off. And if you're wondering how Crispin sweeps the chimney, does he need a brush, Terry? When Crispin sweeps the chimney, does he need a brush? Do you give him a brush? He apparently not. Grandpa Joe, hello. How you doing? So that's it. Mayhem is Crispin. He is the brush. That's I love that. That's great. Mayhem. Where's Mayhem? Mayhem's here somewhere, surely. Mayhem's always in. What did he say? He might have made his excuses, actually. But he made them after I made it to the top of the comments. Otherwise, I would have taken him out. I'm sure. Maybe I misread. No, we're going to miss tonight's stream as I'm going out. I'll catch a replay tomorrow. Have a good one. He's nice enough to leave a message. Had that been before I'd done top of the comments, trust me, he would not have been number one. Katrina Dennison can be our pop princess. I'll send you a gold disc. Because yeah, I think out of everyone, you've had the most number one hits of the year. Like I say, if I promise to send you things, you will get them. If you've sent me your address on the email, I will send you stuff. So it'll be little lammy treats, little lammy droppings here and there between now and the time that we decide to return. Terry, you've definitely got some stuff on the way. Katrina, I'm going to send you something. Because you come up with the whole top of the comments idea as well, which is great. And every new year I do my New Year's Honours list. And Terry, there's a certificate of your name on it I never sent. And I know some people want prizes, some people want picks. These picks are very cool because if you hold them up to your mobile phone, they take you to a secret website. Oh, yes. Lammy picks. They're lamb. These are the misprinted ones. There's probably some better ones. Look at that notch. That notch is when I did that bit in the private investigations earlier. The Paul Crisman isn't into, try living with him in that clock. That clock of yours is amazing. Some sort of temporal vortex where no matter what time the stream starts, that clock always dings out 5 o'clock. Bang. Amazing. Slip disc would be nice. Right, thank you for the suggestion. Don't forget to go see Jimmy Riddle Show on tomorrow, 7 p.m. Absolutely, another great supporter of the channel. I like Jimmy Riddle Show. Good old-fashioned variety. That's what you want. Have a look at this, right? Here's something. Now, a few times I've tried to do the news, and sometimes it's interesting because what stories come up that pique my interest? But I don't do it a lot because most of the time it's nonsense, right? But I just wanted to draw your attention to this. So here's the thing, right? Youngblood. Anyone know Youngblood? I didn't. And Youngblood, responsible fan, who accuses him of miming his guitar playing. You are a bully and wants a little ounce of attention. I assume that's what Youngblood is saying, and that's not the criticism of his guitar playing. So they're basically saying that this lad is miming his guitar. The accusations he was miming during a recent guitar performance. And he said claiming the guitar's not even plugged in for sake. And then the Doncaster posted a thread of two. So here's the thing, right? I look at this at face value. It's an old man. I'm 38 now, right? Can I use old man as a term yet? I hope so. Certainly rock and roll terms, I'm an old man. As an old man, I look at this and you think, oh, you see, the youngsters, not as good. They don't know what they're doing. They're miming. It's all fake. It's rubbish. It's crap, etc., etc., right? And I caught myself. I thought, oh, that's old lamb brain talking there, right? What's the actual truth here? Because there's two interesting things to this. So I have never heard of this young man. I get this. I'm using all of these terms. I've never used these before. I've never heard of this young man until today. So, you know, initial gut reaction. Oh, he's rubbish. He won't be as good as a guitarist. So anyway, right. But I hadn't heard of him. So I went to seek him out. And I found a video. Here, guitar tutorial with Youngblood, right? This guy's popular. Not aimed at me. Not my generation of music, right?
What's going on? It's Youngblood, and welcome to my music lesson on BBC Radio 1. I'm going to teach you my new song, Weird, right now, right here. So for
a start, he's got a lovely guitar there, by the way. That's a Gibson Hummingbird, I think. Someone may correct me if I'm wrong. I think that's... No. Or is it the dove? It might be the... I don't know. I can't see either animal on there. I think it's a hummingbird. Anyway, it's one of these sort of Gibson acoustics guitars, right? So he goes on, and he goes on to explain now. He explains how to play his song, right? And when you look at him playing, right? Hang on, what do I go back here?
Fret 7, 9, 11, and 12. And this is the rhythm of it.
So he goes through the rhythm of it. He plays it through.
6 8 6 4 6 8 6 8.
Oh, so he talks about the numbers that he's playing, what fret numbers he's playing.
Chorus, and then back to the chorus. To repeat.
Now I'm trying to find a bit where you outlined the chords he was playing as well. There we go. Here, my point is.
And now we're going to the chorus, which starts on G-sharp minor.
Right, so here's the thing, yeah? If you're a beginner at guitar and you write a song, you don't write a song that starts on G-sharp minor because you have to do a bar chord, you have to play it well, you have to ring it out. You know, here's your G-sharp minor. That isn't a straightforward chord to start on. And there's the rhythm of his song. He actually goes to this song.
Down to E.
See, this lad knows how to play guitar. And this... Oh, no, don't... you bastard. Oh, I do that almost every week. He knows how to play guitar. So I started on this, thinking of ripping on him. Actually, he knows his stuff, and he plays it well. And it's nice to see a young man play guitar. But you know what I mean? This guy must be popular. He's on BBC and whatever. He's good. So, I thought, well, maybe, you know, you can't really shit on him for miming, because here's the second bit of my story, right? Here is David Gilmour. This is a Meltdown concert put on by Robert Wyatt quite a while ago. It's a Shine on a Crazy Diamond. This is the second part, and it's acoustic, right? And this is David Gilmour. So earlier we saw Youngblood, young man, been criticised possibly for miming. Someone said he's miming. He said, no, I'm not. You can see he knows how to play the guitar, right? That should be enough to get behind him, in my opinion. He's young and he's playing guitar to, you know, he's keeping it alive. Here's David Gilmour at Robert White's Meltdown. That's quite interesting what happened there. If you watch that bassist again, just to get this in your memory, watch him as he plays the note. Boom, yeah, all fine, right? Keep watching him. Plays another couple of notes there. We're okay at the moment. Keep watching him. All normal. Now when the drums come in, now watch him. Did you see it? See if we spot that again now. I'll make my point in a second. See, now here's the thing. I don't know if anyone noticed this in that bit there. But if I go back here somewhere, where is it? It's going to play it again. Where's my pointer? Here's my mouse pointer, ready? Watch him. Oh, I missed it. I might have missed it. I might have gone too far. There he plays. It's just as the drums come in. I've gone back a bit far. There. Did you see it? Did you see it? So what's happening? The drums come in. The bass play. You hear the bass go thump, thump. Watch his fingers. Here, watch his fingers. Watch his fingers. Do you see that? You hear the bass, he doesn't play. And I know it's hard to spot. So this time he'll play. The next thump thump, watch his fingers. He's not playing that. He's miming. Do you see it? The bass made a noise. He didn't play it, but you heard the bass. I'm going to go back now and show you a couple of other things that will, if you don't pay attention, this stuff sails past you, right? I got another example after this. Watch Gilmour again. Watch his thumb. He strikes a string and you don't hear it. You should hear it, like, you know, you should hear an impact, right? Watch. There. He struck the string, no change in the sound. He's fiddling with the controls. No change in the sound. Are you getting the idea yet of what's actually going on here? He's actually plucking things and you're not hearing it. And the other thing you may notice, the camera is not focusing on this solo at all. Normally when guitars play solo, they close up. There's very little close up of this. we're off him again. Now we're back on, and it looks about right. That looks okay. What was all that extra hand movement there? Let's go back a little bit again. There's a lot of hand movement, a lot of picking. There. And then almost like a cut. Now, he's not playing at this point. You can't play these things stood up like that. It doesn't work. The bar has got to be flat, heavy on the strings to send them out like this. So he's standing up. He's hitting a pedal. Pedal makes a big difference in the sound. You know, for me, if I get a hit pedal, I'm going from to, you know, or I'm going from to, you know. He's stood up, but it sounds like he's still going, right? So here's the truth. Watch that again. The truth is, nothing that you're hearing is live. Nothing. That entire track, they've played it on the night. Gilmore or someone has gone, I'm not happy with that, we can't put it out. They've gone into the studio and they've played to the video to make it match up as much as they can, but you really can't, because obviously there were some mistakes being made. Gilmore didn't have the right pedal on, or something was distracting him. The bass player should have been playing every bar and he's playing every two, and so these mistakes are going on. So they've gone into the studio afterwards and redone it. And all I'm thinking, and that happens a lot, a hell of a lot, right? The Police have got this great video out. Wrapped Around Your Finger, live in Japan, 2008. I'm blowing the doors off. It's my last stream. I don't care, right? It's time you knew the truth. This, right? Before I go any further, it's a three-piece band. You've got Sting on bass. The guitar is being covered by the guitarist whose name I've forgotten. And Stuart Copeland's playing the percussion, three-piece band, right? But listen, there's extra stuff going on because... Hear that? So there he's playing that bell line with his right hand, right? That, na, 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 na. You can see there. Playing that. But hang on. Who's playing the congas? Listen again. Andy Summers, thank you. Listen again. I can hear bass, percussion, guitar, congas. Who's playing the congas? Anyway, a bit further on in the song, it comes down to the full kit to play. It's a great song, this, by the way. Where's the bit where he comes down to the kit? But yeah, throws the sticks away. But there's still rhythm. There's still congas. There's a hi-hat going... The rhythm hasn't stopped. There are two people playing instruments there. The point is, they all do it. If you purchase it's a proper release by a big band, everyone, Pink Floyd, Sting, it doesn't matter who they are. They all go into the studio afterwards. Delicate Sound of Thunder is a really popular, well-known Pink Floyd live album. David Gilmour admitted long, long time ago, he said that album was made in the studio. We went in the studio and overdubbed everything to get better sound quality. Exactly, backing tracks, exactly, things like that. But were they being played live or was it overdubbed? I mean, you'll never know if that backing track was going out live or it had been overdubbed. They could be playing to a click. My point is... You can't jump on a young lad. It almost annoyed me that there's this young lad who's quite a quirky personality, but he can play. He knows his stuff. He explains his chords. He plays his song well. They're accusing him of, oh, you're miming his guitar. he probably wasn't. He probably wasn't miming his guitar. But the reality is, they all do. Roger Waters doesn't sing anymore. He mimed. They all do it. It's part of the... They're putting on a show. None of your business in the audience to know. It's a good show. Stop picking on young musicians that are playing guitar. That's my point. Anyway, just thought I'd point that out. That was the news today that actually caught my attention. Because I started off with the mindset of, oh yeah, young pop lad, he won't be playing, it won't be plugged in. And actually, when I dug a bit deeper, seems like he knows what he's in. Bit of Ticket to Ride, Mark Hodgson. Why not indeed? She's got a chicken to ride. Chicken to ride. Oh, how's that riff go? Hang on. I just gotta figure out the riff at the start. That's the one. Everyone likes a bit of Beatles, don't they? Here we go. Ooh! That's on radio voiceover mode. Right, take us back to where we came from. One, two. Wait, where does it start? Where does it start? How many times around?
I think I'm gonna be sad. I think it's today. Yeah. The girl that's driving me mad is going away. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. And she don't care. She said that living with me is bringing her down. Yeah. She would never be free when I was around. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. She's got a ticket to ride. And she don't care. She'll do right by me before she gets to say goodbye. She'll think twice. She'll do right by me. I think I'm gonna be sad. I think it's today. Yeah. The girl that's driving me mad is going away.
She's got a ticket to ride. She's got Sorry, I went a bit twangy at the end.
My baby don't care. She doesn't. She couldn't give a toss, my baby. My baby couldn't give a flying fudge. She just don't care. Thank you. Thank you for your suggestion. A lot of Beatles stuff, isn't it? Joe Clark, I think it's high as well, some of that Beatles stuff. Joe Clark, Jimmy Riddle Show, C&K. Rock on the Lamb. Rock on, Sherry Lynn. Nice one, Mark Hodges, Swanson, Chris R, Jeremy Holly, Richie, Reese H, Chris R, Batman. You could bring this all the way up to the top there. Love the Plague singing. Thank you, C&K. Not bad. It's a bit Paul McCartney. What a hell of a voice. Incredible voice. Paul McCartney at his finest for me, because we don't care about copyright, and my windows are going all crazy today. For me, this is it. It's I don't know if you've heard this song. I think I've played it out once on the stream before. Monk Berry Moon Delight. Oh, what a vocal. There's something about Paul McCartney when he really pushes his rock voice. The sound, like, there's some quality to his voice that I find incredible. And this song, he pushes it more than anything. I mean, where is it? It's like here somewhere. This vocal is crazy. That's a cool song as well. But listen to this vocal. Ram is his best album for me. I'm trying to find this one, but it reminds, I'll tell you what it reminds me of. Steven Tyler, Aerosmith. That's crazy vocal. Anyway, listen to Toya Wilcox today. She sounds good now than she did before. Yeah, Toya's just smashing it at the moment. Did a festival up in Newbury about a year and a half ago, and she was the headliner up there. And wow, she's brilliant, like Toya. Very good. Very entertaining, especially on the old YouTube. But yeah, Ram. I love Ram. Best thing he did, I think. I'm not a massive McCartney fan, you see. Like, when you look at, when I listen, I spoke about this, but when you listen to the Beatles albums and stuff, and you listen to what is actually a McCartney song and what is a Lennon song, McCartney songs are always a little bit, I don't know, Lennon just had the real edge to me. Lennon came from a darker place, I think. That's quite like it. But you know, like you look at Sgt. Pepper, When I'm 64, She's Leaving Home, beautiful songs, it's kind of a bit twee, if you will, you know. And then Lennon's got, like, you know, well, all just I was gonna look, but you got things like Lucy in the Sky, Day in the Life, Frog Chorus, yes, Frog Chorus, visually pleasing indeed for a lady. She's incredibly well for a lady of age. She's an attractive lady, is that old Toya. What am I looking at here? Got all sorts of stuff up that we could do. How long have we got? What time is it? Bloody hell, it's 8:30. The theory, conspiracy about the 1965 car accident. We got killed. The Paul is dead rumor. Complete horse twaddle, obviously. because the rumor was his name was it Mark David Chapman or something like that? They held a lookalike contest. So the idea, if you don't know, the idea was that in 65 was a car accident, Paul McCartney was killed. So they ran a lookalike contest. So I think it was William Campbell, wasn't it? William Campbell supposedly won this lookalike contest for looking like Paul McCartney. And he took over as Paul McCartney, which you think, well, okay. The chances of finding someone, because have you really ever seen two people who look exactly alike? Like, to the point where you go, oh, the same person. That's very unlikely. But for that person then to go on and write things that Paul McCartney wrote, no, obviously, it's nonsense. But it's a good story. I like, and all the album covers and things. And I think at one point the Beatles admitted it was, they knew about it and they were in on it to a degree. I think the 28 if on the Beatle on Abbey Road, Paul McCartney was in on that because he would have been 28 if. And I think by the time they got to Abbey Road, they were playing it on a bit because someone had come to them, and I think it was like a university person, had said, oh, look, we've got this idea where we could do this thing. I'm pretty sure they knew more about it than they knew about it anyway. But fun, all good fun. The one to look into, Terry, if you really want a mysterious thing, is look into Pink Floyd. Search for Publius Enigma. Right, now that... let me show you that. I'm sure I've pointed this out before. If you go to Another Brick in the Wall, part two, right at the end, some things cut this off, but when the kids are playing... I don't know if you can hear this. We have to, well, I'll turn this up loud, right? Did you hear that? After, when the kids are playing, after the, you, if you don't eat your meat, you can't have any pudding. And this is on the original pressing. It's been on there since day one. A kid screams at the top of his lungs the word the Enigma. All right, listen. But 3, 2, 1. You hear that? That kid shouts Enigma. If you go and search Pink Floyd Enigma or Publius Enigma, something there huge was going on. And in that case, there's absolutely no doubt that it's a real thing because of stuff like... This was 1994. It was on the Division Bell tour. Across the front of the stage, the words Enigma, Publius, right? So an album released in, what, 79, The Wall, has got a kid shouting Enigma on it. 20 years later in the 90s, they're going out live. Roger Waters, nothing to do it anymore. The words appear across the stage. There's loads and loads of stuff behind this to look into. If you want to look into the Publius Enigma, there it is again, another picture of it. The boatman unraveling the Publius Enigma of the messages. There's that one where it appeared drawn on the back of the stage, and then someone actually scribbled it out live, which is quite cool on like a 120 foot stage. I tell you, the bands do some cool things. He was shouting Bogner. Is that what it was? So that, maybe that's what it, Bogner. I can do a bit of Pink Floyd to end, by the way. Blackbird is a classic. You know what? I thought, oh, I've never learnt it. And it's an interesting song because it was... you can tell I've never learnt it. Can't believe it. How did it go? God, I forgot. I was practicing it a bit earlier, and I just thought, no, there's no way. Because it's interesting, because it's very... It's hard to explain why it's interesting. I won't get into it, because I can't play it, so I'll be floundering. But it's a very cool song, and I'll know that by the time I come back, because I'll learn that one. We'll do that. That'll be on season 2 of the Land live stream, which will be sometime next year. Shouting Bogner. The Undertaker, the Gravedigger Corpse, and the other one. Oh, yes, that's right, because they were, yeah, because Paul McCartney was barefoot, so he was supposed to be the corpse, wasn't he? George Harrison was a gravedigger because he was in double denim, I think. There's the other thing as well, in the video for, like, Your Mother Could Know from the Magical Mystery Tour, and they're all coming down the stairs in, like, their white dinner jacket suits. They've all got, like, a red carnation, except for Paul McCartney's, who's got a black one. You know, and you think, why... Surely, you know, when the costume department are putting these guys ready, they say, oh, you all got the... Why did he get a black one? So they knew. I'm sure they were doing stuff on purpose like that. Yeah, and that probably was it. I like, you know, there's loads of shots and things like that. The amount of stuff you can look into. You know, it's that whole thing, like, that you can line up Dark Side of the Moon with The Wizard of Oz. And I've done that. I've done that when I was younger, and you play the... When the lion roars, you play, press play on Dark Side of the Moon. And a lot of it does seem to line up, but it's all just, you're just looking for patterns, you know, and it's just coincidence, really. Yes, Elsie Miles as well. Subscribe to Elsie Miles. But, How about a bit of the Who? Who wants the Who? Need smoke for the Who. I haven't done the Who in a while. Let's try. See if we wake the neighbours up, shall we? Didn't put the talent button on. All right, shut up, you. Take two. Oops. I need the lasers back on. We'll be fighting in the streets with our children at our feet, and the morals they all worship will be gone, and the man who spilled his own to the judgment of all wrong, and they decide the shotgun sings a song. I tip my hat to the new constitution. And the chain over. What the hell? And I know that the hypnotized never lie. Songs is like too many versions. That'll be a radio edit or something with a cut down bit. I want to do the whole thing, but never mind. Backing track didn't want to play. Thank you, Batman, Rita H, Rizzio, Chris R, Jimmy Riddle Show. It's a bit of a mess, but then, you know, Sherry Lynn Flicker, Mark Dennison. That's one of the problems when there's different versions of songs. You never know what the backing track's going to do. Is it a radio edit? Is it meh? Smoke's going to get in my eyes. Smoke never gets in my eyes. It's proper theatre-grade stuff, so I'm all right. what are we looking at? 2043. For anyone that's on a replay, please like and subscribe to Lamb at no cost to you. Yeah, no cost. Free. Come on. Broadband bill, I suppose. Captain Ray Paul, thank you for your applause. Simon Ferry, Joe Clark, please share. Yeah. Yeah, when I'm gone, when I'm away, if you can, like, get some people in. Like I say, people are welcome to subscribe and keep the bell off. Any more requests? I'm not doing the Ace of Spades again. The Ace of Spades. Oh, hello.
My Cotchburns tipped £5. TFFT, I thought it was going to be a complete Beatles fest. Splitter.
It could be a splitter. Oh, the People's Front of Judea. What have the Beatles ever done for us, eh? Apart from Abbey Road, the White Album, of course, and Revolver, yes. Apart from that, apart from Abbey Road, the White Album, and the Revolver, what have the Beatles ever done for us? All right, just Help. Yeah, and look at Hard Day's Night. Apart from Hard Day's Night and Help. Traveling Wilburys at the End of the Line. That's another one. I haven't looked into much of their stuff. Song suggests the final can. We're heading to Venus. I don't think I can sing that. Have I got a piano? No, I haven't got a piano either. Rubbish. I thought I had a Moog set up. Oh, there we go. Moog. Moog. Hey, Brad G. Hey, sorry to be late. That's fine, no problem at all. It's the last one. Just caught the end of the last one. right, one song, one more song, and then my finale. And then we'll say goodnight, and thank you very much. Everything on my list, you see, is stuff that I thought I might do and then not do. They're all traps. So I look at my list, I'm like, oh, that's a trap. Something by you too, says Simon Ferry. Go on then. That's a trap as well, but okay. Which one? Ooh. Hattie James.
Hattie Jack tipped £5. Can you play Forever and Ever by Demis Roussos, please? Forever oh, matron. Ever and ever, I
need your love. Do. Demis Roussos, wow. There's a... The only reason I know Demis Roussos is from a Freddy Starr sketch where he dresses up as him and he's singing that song. Forever and ever. And then as he steps across the stage and as he does, his big poncho that he used to wear sort of reveals there's a man underneath him with a pair of pliers just like that. That's the only way I know Demis Roussos. Hattie Jakes is good as well. Hattie Jakes is brilliant. Thank you very much as well. That's really kind of you to donate and stuff like that. There's a bit in the kitty. That's what I'm going to use to send stuff out between now and Christmas. Maybe when we come back, who knows, we might have something to give away as well. So it's all brilliant. Thank you. I'm not going to do it because I only know of it. I don't know it that well. I am going to do something by you too. Something that I probably can't sing, but it's just, we'll just bash them out. And this could be a... Okay, we're in. Let's see how this goes. I don't think I can sing this. So, let's do it with Gary Moore. We'll see what we can squeeze in. I might not have time.
JFK, snow.
Tiffany, the charcoal train of the love supreme. I said she has got to be an angel. Lady Day got diamond eyes. She sees the truth behind the lies.
Be the police around now. You've been abusing animals in here. We heard a scream. Oh, good God. Thank you very much. Thank you, Hattie Jakes. Thank you, Rita H. Thank you, Captain Rabel, Badman, Coroidal. Pardon me. Captain Rabel, Chris R. Sherry Lane, Simon Ferry, Reed Shield, Bob MUK, CNK, Joe Clark, Jesus Hannah, Mark Denison. Awesome, Mark Denison. How come the emoji still? I know. The witches' hats need to go. Come on, fellas. It's YouTube that are doing that. Or it might be Stream Elements, actually. Stream Elements that are doing that. Maybe I can turn it off. Hello and goodbye, everyone. I've had a very good fun. The Lambers are ready. Thank you, CNK. I hope you can come back to us soon as well. I want to see you do some more of your Elvis and really good stuff. Been hooked on bogey since 2018. Croyder's lip syncing is the best we can all do. Right. Thank you very much. Let's do one more. And then. Who knows what will happen? So this is it. This is really the end, isn't it? This is really the end now. So if you, please do say stay subscribed. Please do hang around. I'll be back. We gotta take a break. We gotta figure this out again, so it comes back and it'll be interesting. You know, I'll go away and I'll prepare new bumpers and new graphics and stuff like that, and who knows what I'll do to the room. We might move it around. And for now, it's the end. This is the end, my friend. Yeah, the Doors. And if you can get anyone to come along, please do. There'll still be videos, but there might be taggy stuff. You can share them around, that'd be great. I've had an absolute ball doing this, and we'll be back Christmas. Oh, I'll be back. I say we, you guys, hopefully. No one shows up, then it's over, right? If I come out and there's no one, finito. Who do you think I know, right, Dr. Nate? How dare I? I see no financial return from this. I will be back soon, I'm sure, but definitely Christmas Day will be one a special one. We'll do Christmas Day one, New Year's Day, and then we'll see. So keep an eye. If you want to come join the Discord or whatever, the link's in the thingy below. If you want to follow me on Facebook, I've only got like 70 followers on Facebook. But I keep posting stuff on there, you know, saying hello and stuff. There's Facebook. If you want to send me an email for whatever reason, you want me to come down and jam with you? Maybe. Make that happen. Nope, that was not working. That was not working. So we pretend that doesn't happen. TheLamb@TheLambLive.com. Chickens? Have we got chickens? We've got chickens. So, you know, your donations have kept the chickens fed now nicely for quite a while. That's the one on his own. I think that's the ghost chicken after Halloween. Ghost chicken. But your donations have kept them fed, so that's good. I'll have to wear a Santa suit. Oh, fuck off, Mike. The problem I have, if I go to a costume shop and put an order a Santa suit and put it on, it is the most comfortable suit I've ever worn. It fits me perfectly. Nothing more demoralizing than ordering big saggy Santa pants and a big top and a bit, and you realize actually this is the best fitting clothes you've ever had. Oh, I love you a long time too. And like I say, it's been amazing. This, all of you guys, I feel like I know some of you. You know, well, I do know some of you now, and that's all good. So we're just airing it out. We're airing the stream out. I don't want to get stuffy. I don't want it to get complacent or consistently boring. You know, we're dreaming it all up again. Come back, and who knows what forms things will take. Maybe I'll find a band between now and then. And this is the thing, Sherry Lynn, always great surprises packed into your show, Lamb. And this is one of the reasons I'm stopping. I don't think I can keep coming up with them. You know what I mean? The Halloween one was great, you know, because all of those cool spooky things and stuff like that. But me just sitting here playing the same songs again and again and again, eventually it'll get boring. So we're just going to have a break. We're having a season break, hiatus. And, you know, like I said, I've got a studio booked in January to go and do some stuff with some people in a secret location. That'll be fun. We'll live stream from there. I might contact a few people, maybe see if they want a visit. You know, I might pop up on some other channels. Maybe Terry, if he's accommodating. Don't know. I don't want to impose myself. Certainly, I think Mike, CGS, has possibly offered. There's a few people. Brent Hutchinson. There's a few people around we might go and say hello to. So we're gonna go for the end. Stick around right to the end. It's always fun. And this has been one of my most favourite things to do. There's been an update on the traveling guitar, Dr. Nerd, in the Discord there. Gunter's investigation into the courier appears to have revealed that customs have opened it and screwed. Basically, they've seen some nice things that Gunter's put in there and looked at the description and gone, oh, this isn't the same. And they've done. Hopefully, it'll get resolved and we can figure it out. But I didn't even know you'd put all that. I was expecting just to get a guitar. So the fact you put the extra stuff in there to make it super cool, and then, you know, it's got lost at customers. Brexit for you. It's a nightmare. Thank you, Terry. And Terry, big thank you to Terry, because anyone, you know, like yourself, serious weight channels. One of the reasons there's 30 to 40 people come to this all the time is because of your channel and all the lovely people there. Terry Miles, Acoustic Milestone, Elsie Miles, Kevin Miles. Thank you so much. I'll do me proper thanks at Christmas and New Year. I can't wait to the Christmas show. I can put a lot of effort into it. You see, I've got time now. I've got time. Because this is the other thing. With the constant Mondays, it's like a rolling thing. Because I work the week. So now till the end of Friday is done. So then Saturday, I'm thinking about the next Monday stream. And it's like, I can't do it. You know what I mean? And it's just a bit like that. So that's why it needs a bit. Here, I'm going to end on something that should be fun. Shall I fire up the laser? Should we have a laser session just for the last? Give me one. No, sorry, we won't do lasers. We've all seen it. It's just for show. We'll do the song. And yeah, let's see what happens. The lunatic is on the grass. I don't know where it starts. The lunatic is on the grass. What's it there? The lunatic is on the grass. Remembering games and daisy chains and laughs. Got to keep the loonies on the path.
The lunatics are in the hall. The lunatics are in my chat. The paper holds their folded faces to the floor. And every day the paper boy brings more. And if the dam breaks open many years too soon, and if there is no room upon the hill, and if your head explodes with dark forebodings too, I see you on the dark side of the moon. The lunatic is in my head. The lunatic is in my head. You raise the blade, you make the change, you rearrange me till I'm sane. You lock the door and throw away the key. There's someone in my head, but it's not me. And if the cloud bursts thunder in your ear, you shout and no one seems to hear. And if the banjoing starts playing different tunes, I see you on the dark side of the moon.
Keyboard. Analog Corner on Thursday, Terry Cobb. Here we go then.
All that you touch and all that you see, all that you taste, all you feel, and all that you love, and all that you hate, and all you distrust, all you save, and all that you give, and all that you deal, and all that you buy, beg, borrow, or steal, and all you create, and all you destroy, and all that you do, and all that you say,
no dark side of the moon, really. Matter of fact, this is all dark. And then normally this is where the lady would talk, but I'm going to do it. So thank you all for joining us at Central this evening. I hope you enjoyed the film. you might have been hiding behind a chair at the end of it. Join us tomorrow at 8:30 for some other nonsense that we do on Central. Sonic, shut the music. That's enough of that. Thank you very much, everyone. I love you all to pieces. This has been the best thing ever that I've probably done ever. Please hang around. Please come back. Please wait for me. And I'll see you at Christmas. Have a lovely November. Have a lovely December. That's it. As the young lady says, that's it. Now piss off. See you in the Discord. Peace. Lamb out. Bye. That's it. Seriously, now piss off.